Hi everybody and welcome back to tip 11 on using MIDI in ProTools. So last week we looked at putting in the hi-hat with the keyboard, but this week we're going to do it by hand. And so what we do first is we go to track, new. We could choose mono or stereo, but we'll use stereo for now and we'll create a stereo instrument track. Then on the insert we'll choose expand. And in expand, we'll go down to drums and choose the hi-hats menu. And then we will go up to window, MIDI editor. And up here at the top on grid, we are on quarter note. And what we can do is we can sample or we can listen to each hi-hat sound that we have in the hi-hats menu by clicking these keys here, which correspond to a keyboard here on the left. So what, I'm going to choose this one. We'll just listen to that. Now this is a tip 11. If you want, I'll put the card up now if you want to go back to the beginning and start listening to or looking at the videos that I've already made. It's a series of videos which is now on tip 11. So if you feel it's too far in, you can go back if you click that card, and I've already drawn in some chords that is going to play along with the hi-hat now. So as you can hear, that's a nice little hi-hat section. Now in one of the previous videos as well, I'm just going to click the hand here at the top. In one of the previous videos I spoke about velocity. So if we click that and go down here, we can pull down the velocity on that one and this one, just to make it more human sounding and not be just as robotic sounding as it is without changing the velocity. Because if a person was hitting a hi-hat in real life, they wouldn't be hitting it at exactly the same velocity every time. So that's where you can change these, just to make it more human, if you want. Then what we could do is, we're still on the hand, we could drag over the mouse and we could control D on a PC. And that will just duplicate them. It will save us drawing in another four notes. It can speeds up the process. So that's the tip for this week. It's just on hi-hats. I'm going to release another tip next week, which is just a continuation on of these videos on using MIDI in ProTools. If you're a beginner, it can help you along and you can learn the whole process of creating MIDI in ProTools. And at the end of this video now, I'm going to put up a link to a playlist of videos which is more detailed in creating MIDI tracks or MIDI songs, instrumentals in ProTools, all using expand and all using stock plugins. It goes through the whole process of layering the tracks from bass to drums to keys to pianos to synths, all different kinds of tunes. There's about six in there at the moment. And if you want to check that out. And then tomorrow, Friday, I'm going to release another track which was an instrumental, was also made in Pro Tools with expand, all stock plugins. So that's the video for this week, folks. Hope you enjoyed it and you learned something from it, and hopefully see you in the next video. Goodbye for now and thanks for watching.